Hi, and thanks for joining me in my shop. We're going to try to finish off this music box radio with the capacitors it needs in its power supply, which I have right here. I had to run to the parts store and buy these very expensively because somewhere I placed my electrolytic capacitor stock and I can't find it. And I'm starting to think I've thrown it all out by accident. I got it mixed up with something and it's got thrown out. I don't know what else to think. So anyway, here we are. So these are the last two capacitors we're going to need to finish off the radio. So, now just a word about my videos. Got a couple comments about the very slow frame rate. And yes, I am well aware of what's happening here. I am totally unaware of exactly why. But it does appear that my video frame rate is falling. And I spent quite a few hours yesterday, rather than work on radios, to work on my video system here after having a few revelations, and the result is everything is exactly the same way it was as far as I can tell here as I'm shooting, because I really have to look at the recorded video to see the result. So I apologize for the low frame rate. The other side of that picture is the high definition video I'm producing. The cameras are taking very detailed images and also widescreen, and this results in a big mouthful of data every time the camera takes a shot, and that mouthful of data doesn't get through my computer quite so well, and so the frame rate drops to compensate for the volume of data. That's what's happening. The result is you get this stuttery video, but the images themselves, as long as the camera and the objective are still, is very good. So I'm going to leave it just this way while I continue to ponder how to make things better. So now let's put in these capacitors here. So the one that was in there, let me take another look at it. A 50, a 20, and a 10. And the red and yellow, 50 and 20. So I'm just going to be putting in two 50s here instead of a 50 and a 20. I wasn't smart enough to buy a 20 microfarad capacitor. So I'm just going to twist together the negatives here. They're the shorter leads on these. Okay, I'm pretty sure this is going to fit fairly nicely in like this. Let's see if I can find a spot I want. I really want to hold them down too somehow. They can sit. They can sit right in there. Better yet, they could sit like that. But I don't see any way to hold them down. That's a bit of a problem, isn't it? Because they're going to be soldered to these wires, and they're not going to provide any physical support. I just don't even see the holes I need. You know, there's a great spot right in here. Look at that. There's a hole right here. I think I might have to drill a hole in the chassis here so I can put a band around it, put a tie wrap around it, hold these guys down. That's a perfect spot for them. Maybe even this way. should be, there's a yellow. Not very stiff wires. Yeah, I'm going to have to drill a hole through that. Okay, let me get my drill going here. Okay, so I got my drill ready, but I started thinking, wait a minute. What's this hole here for, anyway? And I brought in the cabinet, which is just over here. Took a look at it, and yeah, sure enough, those holes are intended to take a couple of screws to hold the radio in. So if I stick a tie wrap through there, I may interfere later when I go to put the radio back together. There may not be enough space in here. So I'm going to drill two holes. And I just drill them here and here. I'm going to want to keep all the debris from falling into the radio. So something to do that. Don't want the metal filings falling into the radio. Okay, I think that's going to do the trick. Just like that. Hopefully I've got a nice sharp bit. Stuff on the end of my drill there. Let's pull that off there. It's kind of handy. Collecting all the shavings here. There we go. Okay, that's one hole. Not sure my paper's doing much good here. I'll do the next hole. Right there. Yeah, I could have done the one hole thing that was suggested to me. It's a little hard on my shoulder. A little hard on my shoulder because I broke my collarbone out. How long ago now? 2 months ago? Would it be? Okay. How did that happen? That tube just fell out of there? When I shook it? Come on. Ah, really? Gee. It was already knocked loose. There we go. Okay. Oh, my plan is in trouble. How many of you figured this out? Huh. Yeah. Capacitors interfere with the hole that the screw goes down. Completely. Phooey. My plan has gone down the dumper here. There's a couple of screws sticking up from the base. It keeps the capacitors from going in all the way. Leaves them down just far enough to interfere with the hole. What am I going to do now? My wonderful plan. How bad is the interference here? Terrible. Terrible. Completely covers the hole. Well, let's see. There's room for one down there. I suppose I could just move over a little further and do the same thing, abandon these holes. Bolt this in here. That's what I'll have to do. Drill more holes. Okay. Do it over here. Two more holes, please. I just start thinking about how to fix the speaker so it's not loose like it is. Okay, two more holes. Bad here. 20 years from now, somebody will be looking at this radio going, what are these two holes here for? Maybe they'll jump on the internet and my dusty old video will still be there. Okay, one more. In 20 years, this radio will find its way back into my hands. I'll be the guy wondering. Well, I'm not sure I stopped any metal from getting into the radio there. Magnetic filings. Gee, are the filings magnetic? A little bit. That's not too good.
vacuum here briefly. Now, I think we're ready to actually do some work. Let's see.
Okay, they're going to sit very nicely like that. How's the sound today?
Hey, you know what? Maybe I can put a little more volume in it.
How about that? That's a little louder, I think. Actually, I'm a little louder. We'll try like that. Okay. Conductor left there. I'm trimming these pretty short because I really don't want excess wire kicking around. These bare wire, these are high voltage leads in this radio. It's not very high, about 130 volts maybe. Not terribly high. Now, should I attach all these wires and then put this in place? Or should I put it in place and then attach the wires? Should I attach some of the wires, put it in place, and attach the rest? That's the question. Well, one of them's going to be way down here, a little hard to get at. And that's going to be, let's see, red and yellow are the two that I want to attach. The green one is for a different size and rating of capacitor completely. So, and the black one. So you know what? I think. See, the wires are very stiff, so I really don't want to move them around too much. In fact, I'm pretty sure this red one's going to break off here before I'm done. So let's attach them first. I think that's a smarter move. I'm going to be working right up close to the body of the capacitor. That means I want to be fairly efficient with the soldering iron. I don't want to apply too much heat. It's going to get right in the capacitor, that's for sure. That's the red one. black one goes on these. And the negatives here. I'm trying to get it close to its final position here. These wires are all tangled up, in fact. Okay. And the wires aren't the cleanest either. Last one is the yellow one. I think I'll do the yellow one after I strap these in. Fish these stiff wires down here. Ooh. Shorten this yellow one or even get rid of it. You know what? I think I can attach the capacitor straight there. No, not quite. Close, but not quite. Yeah, I suppose I could have even replaced these wires completely. But I do like to leave as much original as I can. Tie wrap here. See if I can hit the camera lens with this. Here we go. Everybody, aiming this right at the camera. Oop, didn't get it. Try again. Here we go. I missed by a mile. There it is over here. Okay, it's the yellow one. Wants to go. I want to interfere with the switch here. Yeah, often, I'm no different than you. When I'm finished doing something, I start thinking again, gee, I could have done that differently. But what's done is done. And there's always a better way to do things. Not always, but often there's a better way to do things. But you don't necessarily have to do everything the best way possible. We can't get through life like that. That old saying, anything worth doing is worth doing right. Yes, there's some truth in that. But if you do everything perfectly right, you won't get a lot done. That's my excuse. Down to the last 2 inches of my solder here. I do have a whole bunch more. Boop, 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 boop. Get back in there. I think I'm going to cook my finger if I'm not careful. Red on the positives, black to the negative. Now, somebody look at that, they'll say it's very clever. Pretty darn solid. Very good. Now, we just have one more capacitor to put on here. This guy is 10 at 25 volts. I think I got one in here. Found earlier. This is 22. Oh, for crying out loud, I did. I had found one that would. I didn't have to put the 50 in here. Here's one that would have been 20. 250. But that's not what I need now. What I need is a 10 microfarads. Oops, at 25 volts. Let me go hunt that guy down.